everybody. I am in my kitchen today because I'm going to give you a tour of my pantry. It's right here behind this door. I am doing a new kitchen series where I show you how I organize my pantry, my cabinets, my cookbooks, my spices, under my sink, all of it. And I'm starting today with the pantry because it is a room within itself in our kitchen. I'm very lucky. I have a big pantry. But don't, you know, be discouraged because you can make a pantry out of anything. You can use a spare cabinet and make it a pantry. You can also buy those individual baking racks like at restaurant supply houses and have like an open pantry that sits out in your kitchen, which is better than nothing. You can turn a closet into a pantry, and I've also had friends who turn part of their garage into a pantry. So usually during the summer, we have all the kids here, 11-year-olds and 12-year-olds and their friends and the 21-year-old kids and anybody else who decides to visit. And usually during that time, our pantry really does get disorganized. No matter how well I have it organized and cleaned up, once all the little kids get here, that is over. So it has become customary for us and for me to like give our pantry a once over right before the holidays. Clean it out, get out anything that has expired, bring old items to the front so I know to use them, and it keeps me organized, number one, in terms of not having to dig around looking for baking items that I'm going to be using over Thanksgiving and Christmas. It also keeps me from having to rebuy stuff that I already have that I just can't find. I mean, how many of us have done that? And I really, really like a well-stocked pantry. Everybody is different. Every family and their needs are different. So no two pantries are ever going to hold the same items. I think really what works for everybody is find what your family uses the most of. Stock up on it. Keep everything nice and tidy. And it will make life so much easier when you're in the kitchen trying to make meals or bake or anything else. So I'm going to give you a before look at my pantry so you can kind of get an idea of when I say disorganized, how disorganized it really was. And then I will take you inside and give you a complete detailed look on how everything is stored, how everything is organized, and hopefully it will give you some inspiration to clean those pantries out, get ready for the holidays, and become more organized in your kitchen so you're more stress-free, you have more time with your family, and you're not worrying about having to dig through cabinets and, you know, find stuff that you're looking for when you're baking or cooking. So without further ado, let me show you what our pantry looked like at the end of summer. Let's have a look. Was that not insane? I mean, how are we going to ever find anything in that mess? So let me show you what it looks like now. Let's get inside. So let's start with the door. I have a rather large pantry. And on the inside door, I have just one of these very inexpensive door hangers. And on this door hanger, there's lots of hooks where you can hang lots of stuff. However, they're still too big to hang at, like, my brooms and stuff, so I don't keep those in this closet. But those work well. And it holds this plastic bag holder, cute one, this kitty cat one. And, you know, it's a dispenser. And I also have some more of my reusable bags right underneath. And then I have this big bag, and this is just more bags of stuff in here or use first. And I also keep my apron here. Now, this is my apron from culinary school, so it's quite old, but it's just one of those things I've lugged around with me for years. I usually bleach it about once a week. You can see I've been cooking, but this is the one I use the most. I have some real cute ones, but I don't really wear those. This is the one I always go to. It's just my normal culinary apron that I was given like the first day in school. So I love that apron. Have so many memories. And this house has a rather large pantry. It's basically a room within itself. And it's got four large shelves, plenty of floor room, and plenty of height. So let me take you inside. We're gonna start with the first shelf and come on down, and I'll explain how I organize everything. So this is the top shelf of my pantry. You can see there's plenty of room to, you know, build up if you have to. But what I keep up here is stuff that I don't use a lot on this shelf and stuff that I don't want Jackson having easy access to on this shelf. So one thing you should consider whenever you're working on your pantry is the age of your child and what you want them to have, what you don't want them to have, and, you know, in terms of how far they can reach and all that. So keep all that in mind while you're organizing your pantry. Up here, I just keep a couple little extra cutting boards. They just kind of live right here next to the wall. I also have my large KitchenAid, and the top is in here. I was making pasta not too long ago. And this is probably not one of the best places to store this because it's so heavy and it's hard to get on and off, but I don't use it every day. I mainly just use it during the holidays or when I'm baking something special. So it just lives right there. All the attachments are right inside, which makes it, you know, really handy. I also have my hand mixer, and this is the Gordon Ramsay. It has all the attachments inside here, and I just keep it here because I can get to it easy. I keep my blender on my counter, but I don't like a lot of stuff on my counter, so this just lives right here, and I can pull it on and off anytime I need to make it. I also have this really cute bee honeycomb base, basically, that I or pot that I keep a lot of our larger utensils in. Now, I have a ton of utensils in my drawers in my kitchen. These are just the stainless steel ones that I don't use every day. I bring these out during holidays and special occasions, but they do live here. Before I use them, I always give them a good wash just in case they've gotten dusty or something. I always make sure they're clean before, you know, putting them down in our food. This is our waffle maker. Now, you can see it's got some waffle stuff on it. My husband used it just like a couple mornings ago to make breakfast for Jackson. But it's just another item that I keep stored up here. I just like it out of the way up tall. It's not something we use every day. We might use it, I'm guessing, maybe twice a month. And a lot of times I used to make waffles and freeze them. And you could just pop them in the microwave or in the toaster, depending on the size of your toaster. But this just lives right here with the other stuff. I do use these quite a bit, but I also mash my potatoes with a potato masher, so I don't always get these down, but they live right there. Up here, I keep 2 liters. Now, I don't want Jackson having easy access to soft drinks. I do have some on the floor, but he usually doesn't go for those. If I keep them on the top shelf, I know he has to actually put more effort into it and has to, you know, get up, make an effort to get them. So they live up high. Also up here we have like my husband's stuff for again martinis and his tonic waters, and his shaker lives right here. I also keep, you know, like my grapefruit juice here in case we want to use it in a drink or whatever. I keep a couple packets of Kool-Aid right here because it is kind of like the drink section. And then over here is kind of like, from here over is kind of like the chip area. And I sort most of our chips. There's a few bags I don't have to, like these Eat Smart by Naturals, these potato and tomato and spinach little strips. They don't have to be in a snack pack. These tortillas really don't have to be in snack packs because nobody in our house just digs in. We only really eat those when we, you know, want to. They just don't get ate like you would a bag of Doritos. These are the bagel chips, and on the berry bag, I keep like the extra bags of flour or the flour that I still have some, you know, in the bags. So they just live back there. In this big, big red mixing bowl is where all of the sweets are. Now, again, I don't want Jackson just having easy access to this. Some of these items are in his snack containers, but what I keep in here are like Linzer cookies, Oreos, honey buns, the Ruffles and Doritos live up here. This is where we keep the extra bags of chips that I have portioned off, the sweets, like the honey buns, the stuff that really, you know, is okay to eat every once in a while. We just don't want Jackson or any of the other young kids having, you know, such easy access to the entire box. I try to budget and make stuff last, and in order to do that, I section things off and have the half of the bag that I have not put out for everybody up high, so, you know, it's just not in sight and not in mind. They just don't think about it when it's that high up. My husband does, however, but Jackson really just doesn't. So on this shelf, I also keep these bag clips. These are just inexpensive little bag clips. They clip right here. We have a whole bunch of our cereals already. But these just live right here, and we just use them anytime we need to. Now, the next shelf is all cooking and baking stuff. So let's start over here. In this drawer right here, this is kind of like baking stuff. Let me just say that. I'll kind of back up. I am on a chair. I also have my really heavy-duty oven mitts right here. I have my everyday ones in the drawer in the kitchen, but these just live right here on the wall. But these are like super heavy-duty. Super, super. Anyway, so this is like baking stuff. And in this jar here is vanilla sugar. So after I scraped out the beans of this vanilla pod, I just added sugar into it. And I need to add some more, obviously. But my husband really likes this in his coffee. And it flavors it like no other. You can use this in recipes. It's amazing. And it's a great way to, you know, still get use out of your vanilla pods. In this jar is usually cinnamon sugar, but recently Scott and Jackson used it all, so I washed this and I need to make some more, but they love that on toast. And it's real simple. It's just, you know, some white sugar and some cinnamon, and sometimes I even grate in some nutmeg. But I keep that in this jar. I just need to add more. I should have done that before this video, but I can just tell you guys about it. And I love the vanilla sugar for baking. Speaking of baking, I have quite a few different flours. I have bread flour, and I like using, let me just get one out. It's easy to get out. These Rubbermaid containers, they're rather large. It can hold a whole bag of flour or sugar. And in this first one, I have bread flour. They stack two deep, so it's super nice. There's bread flour. Here's all-purpose flour. This is light brown sugar. This is self-rising flour. Powdered sugar. And I just used these labels I found at the store. White sugar. Baking cocoa. And these are so handy because I can pull it out. I can measure it straight from here if I really want to. And it's just very convenient. Everybody can find what they're looking for, even though I'm mainly the one who uses a shelf. My husband still can find what he's looking for if he's making French toast, wants some powdered sugar to sprinkle on top. He can easily find it. I also labeled the baking cocoa so they know it's not, you know, like the hot chocolate cocoa. And that's important. You might want to do that in your house. The kids in my house would grab that up and try to make cocoa with it and not know what was wrong with it. White sugar. In these smaller containers, they have a rubber lid. I think I found these at Walmart. I'm not sure. I have my cornstarch, my cornmeal, and my baking powder. I don't keep my baking soda in one because I keep that in the box. I use them around the kitchen, but these are things I would cook with. Cornstarch, cornmeal, and baking powder. Sometimes I make my own cornbread with my cornmeal, but a lot of times I use this to make like fried green tomatoes and stuff like that. So I don't really need a huge container of it. I don't use a massive amount of cornmeal ever. So on to the back. So in the back, I keep like the marshmallow fluff that I use for baking a lot. I keep actually my all natural stevia and sugar blend. I just cannot do straight stevia yet. I can't do it. I'm a sugar girl. And I just can't help it. I keep my raisins that I use for baking. I also love these Crisco sticks, and I keep those right here. And after I open one, I'll just put the container right in the refrigerator. I also, this is the cornbread mix I use. This is the Jiffy cornbread mix. It's cheap and handy. I also keep like Jell-O. This is raspberry in this area. This is more baking stuff, and these are like cakes back here. Cupcake mixes, marshmallows. There's more cookies back here, like sugar cookie mixes that are handy during the holidays. And then we kind of move into these containers. These containers hold more baking items. Let me see if I can pull one out and kind of show you. This one actually contains like sprinkles, cake decorating stuff, piping stuff, more sprinkles. That's what this basket mainly is, the sprinkles and cake decorations and such. This one holds more baking stuff, which is mainly chocolate chips and chocolates, just different baking stuff. I keep my yeast in here for making bread. I also keep like stuff that I've gotten for birthday cakes to make. Just all kinds of stuff, but mainly chocolate is what's in that basket. And then, and those two bins I don't use like on a daily basis, so they just live right there and I can just pull them out for easy access. And then we kind of move on over into like the oils and the vinegars. I know a lot of people use a turntable for these. I just really didn't find that I needed to do that because I can see everything perfect. I know where everything is. I have my different vinegars and my balsamic vinegars back here. Some different oils. And here's a balsamic glaze. These things just live right here next to the kosher salt and the ice cream salt. So I love making ice cream in baggies. I think it's so fun for the kids to do in the summer. So we always have ice cream salt on hand. And I also use a lot of kosher salt in cooking. So that is why I have two boxes, because we use a lot of it. In these two bins is more... Well, and this one is like breadcrumbs, so I have panko breadcrumbs, the cornflake breadcrumbs, plain breadcrumbs, just breadcrumbs, and like here's a fried green tomato mix from Whistle Stop, and they just live right here. I didn't realize when I was cleaning out my pantry I had so many breadcrumbs. In this container, I keep all of my extra spices. So a lot of my spices are up in the cabinet next to my stove. But I have so many that I have an extra bin for them. My stepson loves this Creole seasoning. So he is a Louisiana boy and has that. But I have tons of extra spices in here. This is our taco seasoning that I've mixed up. And it just lives right here in this little bin. It's super handy. I pretty much only dig in this when I run out of some type of spice in the kitchen and I'm worried. But I do want to try to use up a lot of the spices. But dry spices last a really long time and I have them stored well in these little tins. Let me get them out. They work really good for storing stuff, so I have them stored well. And then everything is labeled and clean and organized, super easy to find what, you know, I'm looking for, and so much better than the disorganized mess it was. Also back here is where I keep the two boxes of baking soda. I use those in cleaning a lot and stuff, so I keep those just right back there. That's why I don't just have them in a jar. I thought about it, but I really just use the box like differently than what I would use it out of one of these containers. So here is the next shelf down. On this side is like the pasta side. No pantry of mine would be complete without a pasta shelf. And I love pasta. My husband would beg to differ and say he's not huge on it, but he eats a ton of it. And it's actually pretty funny because we have a very detailed pasta closet, if you will. And I actually love the shelf probably more than any other shelf in my pantry. So these containers are perfect. I really didn't have to label anything because I can see right through them. But again, for my husband, I thought I would make it easier. My son doesn't use this shelf. It would just be Scott or I, but whatever. I went ahead and labeled it to make it easier. And these are long enough for pasta, so that makes it really handy. I have just regular spaghetti here, whole wheat spaghetti here, linguine. Now, I spelled it wrong, and it was like a joke in our house, and my husband thought it was hilarious, so I just left it that way. Just a family thing. Down here, I have white rice. I don't eat a ton of white rice. Nobody in our family really does, but I keep it. I have rigatoni here. I have elbow macaroni here. Bow tie pasta, which is great for salads. And then I have angel hair nest. Can you see the little nest? Right in there. And this shelf can make dinner in a hurry no matter what night it is. I also, in this area, keep extra like quick cooking rice, pasta side dishes, brown rice. I even have this lo mein here because, you know, I kind of consider that a pasta even though it's lo mein. And, Chinese. I also keep this quick cooking pasta salad here. I have a couple classico pasta sauces, but I usually have more. We just used them up. And sometimes in the summer, I'll make my own and store them, but freeze them usually. But I just keep a few on hand because we don't always eat red sauce with pasta. We like brown butter. We like Alfredo. We like it all. And I keep macaroni in the back. And on this shelf, I also keep all of my stock. My chicken stock, which I have 3 of. My beef stock. And in the back here is ramen noodles. I mean, sometimes we just want them. And my kids will love them every once in a while. So I keep a big box right back there. I have my Italian rice here that's good for... I just went blank. Risotto. That's the word I should have known that word. Risotto. Like that every once in a while. And then I have different types of egg noodles. These are the wide ones. These are the really thin ones. And these are the normal ones. Now, I usually make a batch of these in the winter because I make my own pasta a lot. But I really just wanted some on hand that I could have for the holidays and any other meals that might be coming up. So I just went ahead and bought these. But normally I make them. I store them pretty similar to these containers. I also have some of my favorite tomato paste. I love tomato paste in a tube because it can go right in your refrigerator. I just have a little more to use up of my other one, and then I can put this in the refrigerator. But, you know, a lot of times you only need a little bit of tomato paste, and what do? It's the rest of the can. You have to get it out, put it in a baggie, freeze it, or put it in the refrigerator, and it's just too much work. This is genius. And I don't know if you remember, but I had a beautiful teapot on the breakfast table. And Romeo pulled off the tablecloth and broke the teapot. And these are the cups that survived. There's 3 of them. And I keep, like, our mixes in these, like hollandaise sauce. I can make it. I've done it before. But these are so handy, especially on nights that I'm in a hurry and I want something. I have pork gravy and brown gravy. I have ranch in the back cup. But I just made use of these cups because I didn't know what else to do with them. And I might as well get some use out of them, even though the teapot is shattered. So now we're moving on down to the areas where Jackson usually is. So I keep our cereals on their sides. I use these clips to clip them so they can't fall out. And I store the cereal on the side. That way we can see what we have easier. And Jackson has easy access to it. With the clips, it's not going to spill out. And you have easy access to the cereal, which, you know, everyone in my house likes. So I just keep a variety, some healthy, some not so healthy. Just whatever my family's feeling. I also have a bag. Now, I used to love these bags. But here lately, Jackson has just been, like, eating a small box and getting tired of it, let alone a huge bag. So, we don't buy these as much anymore. But these are handy, especially if you have a larger family. And then over here, I have more breakfast items. So, in the breakfast items, I have this bin of oatmeal. I keep our quick cooking oatmeal in here because it stays fresher. All of the items stay fresher in the sealable containers. I think I actually found these at the dollar store for $1 a piece. Fabulous deal. I keep our oatmeal here because I know how to make quick cooking oatmeal. I don't have to have the box. I don't like the cardboard boxes to store stuff in most of the time, so I keep those here. I have these separate because this is Irish oatmeal, and then I also have a box of Hungry Jack pancake mix. I actually used to keep our pancake mix that I made myself in one of these, which I might start doing again, but I was in a hurry last time I was at the store and just got a pre-made box. But I do have a container. I keep my extra containers in a different cabinet, but I have a container just for pancake mix when I decide to make it. And it's a lot cheaper and easier. I just was lazy that day. In this pull-out basket that I found at Walmart, I keep more small breakfast items, which would include Pop-Tarts, these little plain grain oatmeals. I keep some pineapple. I keep this up here because every once in a while Jackson will pull this out and actually choose fruit for breakfast, even though I have it in a different snack area too, but I keep it up here just in the hopes that maybe he will eat it. I have one of these small summer berry oatmeals by Quaker in here. This usually just has more convenient breakfast items that you can grab when you're in a hurry or just want something small. And that just sums up what's on that shelf right there. Now down here on this shelf is our snacks that, you know, I don't mind Jackson having so much of. So I separate, and I showed it in my last food haul video. It's on this channel. I'll link it below. Sometimes I forget to do that, so please forgive me, but I'll try to remember. I separate a lot of our snacks because I usually buy like 2 bags of chips for 2 weeks, and if I'm not careful, they will be ate up in the first week, both bags. And what I do is break them down into snack packs. Now I use a bigger baggie for Doritos because you just can't fit that many, that, you know, healthy amount into a very small snack pack. But these work perfect for our Cheez-Its. I also put a couple honey buns down here. I don't put a ton. I just put a few of each item. I do have the whole bag of ginger snaps, but those are actually mine and Jackson don't like them, so I don't really worry about that a whole lot. But this is just more snacks that he can grab. And I also keep fruit here because sometimes if he's coming in after school, he'll grab one of these. And these don't have to be refrigerated, so that's what's really nice about those. And he'll grab one of those instead of chips, which I love. It's awesome. And these make it so handy for him to pull out and put back. In this bin, I keep granola bars. I keep crunch bars, which is granola. I keep peanut butter and crackers. I keep just snacks. And a lot of these are healthier snacks. I mean, he does have some of the Cheez-It grips in here. I don't like the storage of the big bulky boxes. I like taking things out, putting them in containers. There's popcorn back here. There's trail mix. Just more items that Jackson can access. I don't mind him getting one of these, and he can just access it really easy by pulling the bin in and out. Now, in this one, in the middle, I do keep things that are a little bit bigger, such as graham crackers and peanut brittle and animal crackers. Those kind of live in the middle. And then we have more items like chips. There wasn't a lot of room in that one, so again, I separate. And he can just grab one of these. It's portion control. That's all it is. And, you know, cost effective. I keep crackers and stuff like that right here in this bin, too. So Jackson knows that he can reach any of the stuff right here. And then back here on the, in kind of in the corner, I have more box items like stuffing and hamburger helper. This is powdered milk for the kittens. I have some taco meals back here and more stuff for the kittens, which is rice cereal. I just keep like a few box items. We don't eat a ton of processed stuff, but we do have some. We're a family and we want to get dinner on the table fast some nights, and we use some of that stuff. And then I keep my bread in here. Now, you know, if you are somebody who doesn't use a whole loaf of bread in 1 week, I highly suggest keeping it in the refrigerator. I don't really have to do that because we go through a lot of bread. And right now I have these for potato soup that I'm going to make. I have the white wheat. This is the healthiest bread I can really get my family to eat. Just the honest truth. And I keep all the bread nice right here and tidy. I'm pulling it all apart right now. But this is another shelf that Jackson or Sky or I can access really easily. Has our hot dog buns, more bread, more tortillas. That all lives right there kind of at the end of the very first shelf. And then over here, I just keep canned goods. Now, we're not a family that stocks up a ton on canned goods because I really prefer to eat as much fresh or frozen vegetables opposed to canned. I really do like these Allen's cut green beans. I like the seasoned the best. Of course, there's canned tomatoes, roasted red peppers, pumpkin stuff. I do have some soups. Actually, that one was upside down. some lobster bisque, tomato, roasted garlic, and bacon. I have some of these convenient Chef Boyardee things, which Jackson loves. I have some quick chili mix, some chicken breast, you know, some fruit. There's cranberries and other canned fruit. I keep my peanut butter. There's another kind of peanut butter. And French's fried onions. All that kind of stuff just lives right there on that shelf. Again, we just don't have a lot of canned goods. We just are not a big canned good family. We do eat, you know, some. I do have some, but I just don't keep a ton of canned goods around here because I can always pick them up if we need them. But we have a freezer full of frozen vegetables and a refrigerator full of fresh vegetables. And those are always healthier than anything canned. And now moving to the floor. So I know this might not look that organized, but believe me, it is. We'll start right here. Now, I do drink a lot of Coke. We are a family that spends money on soft drinks. We just are. And I save my Coke points, but sometimes I run behind. So I just stack those empty boxes here. And about once a month, I will I will cut the points out and add them to my account. I will probably get a whole bunch of free Christmas cards from Shutterfly with my reward points. I also keep stuff down here for Jackson. Now, I do keep our Cokes here, but Jackson knows without explicit permission he's not ever allowed to have a Mountain Dew or a Coke. But what he is allowed to have are his little punches, these little Kool-Aid jammers. I also have these grape ones and his Yoo-Hoo. He knows that these are, you know, easy for him. There's also juice in the refrigerator, water, milk, lemonade. He has stuff in the refrigerator too, but his drinks that I really want, you know, him to drink if he's going to drink something besides water or milk, or right here. Again, he does like soft drinks, but they're up high and he has to make an effort and have permission before he gets them. And that works out well for all of our kids. Then I keep this bin of potatoes and onions and usually garlic. So I have just some regular potatoes down here. These are the older potatoes. I mean, they're not old, but these are the ones that I want to use up first. The same goes with the onions. I showed in that food haul that I store half of my onions in the refrigerator and the other half in this basket. I will always use the stuff up here first, and then I will either use the potatoes that I have in the bag waiting or the onions in the refrigerator and kind of switch them out. But I always use what's in this basket first. I have also some trays and extra cutting boards and such back here. They just live in that corner. I will always wash them before using them. Then, which is, you know, we always seem to have cans in our house because I use them a lot for different things. And so these are for Thanksgiving breakfast, two different size cans. They're just living here in the pantry. I also keep white vinegar back here. I use that for animals and for cleaning and for cleaning out my coffee pot, all of it. And then over here, we keep like our pet stuff. So you guys know we breed cats. We have a big dog. We have fish. We just have a house full of animals. So we keep our dog food and our cat food. I also keep the charcoal back here. I keep extra paper towels and those cups that we use. I keep litter, even though I have more litter in a different closet. I keep another big bag of dog food, cat food, and that is pretty much our pantry. I'm fairly confident that we will be able to keep it clean and organized for months to come. Just following the system that's in place now. The pasta is so easy to get to. You can make so many dinners just from right here. Right here, you can make a bazillion dinners. And all the cereal and stuff is super easy for Jackson to get to. These baskets with the handles are super easy for him to be able to access his snacks. Drinks up high, so he just can't, you know, grab them without even thinking about if it's healthy, if it's something he's allowed to have. They're up high. They're deep. We have quite a few of them. But everything is organized, clean, and in its right place. So this is how we are staying organized right now in our pantry. And I hope it's inspired you, you know, to clean out your pantry, to clean out your cabinet. whatever you're using for a pantry, and just get it more organized. You know, we eat a lot of pasta, so that's why we have so much of it. I do a lot of baking from school, so, you know, from being in school. And even if I wasn't in school, I came from a woman of cooks who taught me so much more than cooking school. But I keep a lot of that stuff because I do a lot of baking. I do a lot of cooking, so I keep a lot of that stuff. And this is what works for us. Let me know how your pantry is set up, if it's a large pantry, if it's not, how you make your pantry work for you. I would love to hear it all. Be sure to check out my blog at kjaggers.com. There is so much more on the blog, more pictures and info. Be sure to check it out. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I will be back very, very soon. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. To clean those pantries out, get ready for the holidays, and become more organized in your kitchen so you're more stress-free, you have more time with your family, and you're not worrying about having to dig through cabinets and, you know, find stuff that you're looking for when you're baking or cooking. So without further ado, let me show you what our pantry looked like at the end of summer. Let's have a look. Was that not insane? I mean, how are we going to ever find anything in that mess? So let me show you what it looks like now. Let's get inside. So let's start with the door. I have a rather large pantry, and on the inside door, I have just one of these very inexpensive door hangers. And on this door hanger, there's lots of hooks where you can hang lots of stuff. However, they're still too big to hang it, like my brooms and stuff, so I don't keep those in this closet, but those work well. And it holds this plastic bag holder, cute one, this kitty cat one, and you know, it's a dispenser. And I also have some more of my reusable bags right underneath. And then I have this big bag, and this is just more bags of stuff in here or use first. And I also keep my apron here. Now, this is my apron from culinary school, so it's quite old. But it's just one of those things I've lugged around with me for years. I usually bleach it about once a week. You can see I've been cooking. But this is the one I use the most. I have some real cute ones, but I don't really wear those. This is the one I always go to. It's just my normal culinary apron that I was given, like, the first day in school. So, I love that apron. Have so many memories. And this house has a rather large pantry. It's basically a room within itself. And it's got four large shelves, plenty of floor room, and plenty of height. So let me take you inside. We're going to start with the first shelf and come on down, and I'll explain how I organize everything. So this is the top shelf of my pantry. You can see there's plenty of room to, you know, build up if you have to. But what I keep up here is stuff that I don't use a lot on this shelf, and stuff that I don't want Jackson having easy access to on this shelf. So one thing you should consider whenever you're working on your pantry is the age of your child and what you want them to have, what you don't want them to have, and, you know, in terms of how far they can reach and all that. So keep all that in mind while you're organizing your pantry. Up here, I just keep a couple little extra cutting boards. They just kind of live right here next to the wall. I also have my large KitchenAid, and the top is in here. I was making pasta not too long ago. And this is probably not one of the best places to store this because it's so heavy and it's hard to get on and off, but I don't use it every day. I mainly just use it during the holidays or when I'm baking something special. So it just lives right there. All the attachments are right inside, which makes it, you know, really handy. I also have my hand mixer, and this is the Gordon Ramsay. It has all the attachments inside here, and I just keep it here because I can get to it easy. I keep my blender on my counter, but I don't like a lot of stuff on my counter, so this just lives right here, and I can pull it on and off anytime I need to make it. I also have this really cute bee honeycomb base, basically, that I or pot that I keep a lot of our larger utensils in. Now, I have a ton of utensils in my drawers in my kitchen. These are just the stainless steel ones that I don't use every day. I bring these out during holidays and special occasions, but they do live here. Before I use them, I always give them a good wash just in case they've gotten dusty or something. I always make sure they're clean before, you know, putting them down in our food. This is our waffle maker. Now you can see it's got some waffle stuff on it. My husband used it just like a couple mornings ago to make breakfast for Jackson. But it's just another item that I keep stored up here. I just like it out of the way up tall. It's not something we use every day. We might use it, I'm guessing, maybe twice a month. And a lot of times I used to make waffles and freeze them. And you could just pop them in the microwave or in the toaster, depending on the size of your toaster. But this just lives right here with the other stuff. I do use these quite a bit, but I also mash my potatoes with a potato masher, so I don't always get these down. But they live right there. Up here, I keep 2 liters. Now, I don't want Jackson having easy access to soft drinks. I do have some on the floor, but he usually doesn't go for those. If I keep them on the top shelf, I know he has to actually put more effort into it and has to, you know, get up, make an effort to get them. So they live up high. Also, up here we have, like, my husband's stuff for again, martinis and his tonic waters, and his shaker lives right here. I also keep, you know, like my grapefruit juice here in case we want to use it in a drink or whatever. I keep a couple packets of Kool-Aid right here because it is kind of like the drink section. And then over here is kind of like, from here over, is kind of like the chip area. And I sort most of our chips. There's a few bags I don't have to, like these Eat Smart by Naturals, these potato and tomato and spinach little strips. They don't have to be in a snack pack. These tortillas really don't have to be in snack packs because nobody in our house just digs in. We only really eat those when we, you know, want to. They just don't get ate like you would a bag of Doritos. These are the bagel chips. And on the berry bag, I keep like the extra bags of flour or the flour that I still have some, you know, in the bags. So they just live back there. In this big, big red mixing bowl is where all of the sweets are. Now, again, I don't want Jackson just having easy access to this. Some of these items are in his snack containers, but what I keep in here are like Linzer cookies, Oreos, honey buns, the Ruffles and Doritos live up here. This is where we keep the extra bags of chips that I have portioned off, the sweets, like the honey buns, the stuff that really, you know, is okay to eat every once in a while. We just don't want Jackson or any of the other young kids having, you know, such easy access to the entire box. I try to budget and make stuff last, and in order to do that, I section things off and have the half of the bag that I have not put out for everybody up high, so, you know, just not in sight and not in mind. They just don't think about it when it's that high up. My husband does, however, but Jackson really just doesn't. So on this shelf, I also keep these bag clips. These are just inexpensive little bag clips. They clip right here. We have a whole bunch of our cereals already, but these just live right here, and we just use them anytime we need to. Now, the next shelf is all cooking and baking stuff. So, hello everybody, I am in my kitchen today because I'm going to give you a tour of my pantry. It's right here behind this door. I am doing a new kitchen series where I show you how I organize my pantry, my cabinets, my cookbooks, my spices, under my sink, all of it. And I'm starting today with the pantry because it is a room within itself in our kitchen. I'm very lucky. I have a big pantry. But don't, you know, be discouraged because you can make a pantry out of anything. You can use a spare cabinet and make it a pantry. You can also buy those individual baking racks like at restaurant supply houses and have like an open pantry that sits out in your kitchen, which is better than nothing. You can turn a closet into a pantry, and I've also had friends who turn part of their garage into a pantry. So usually during the summer, we have all the kids here, 11-year-olds and 12-year-olds and their friends and the 21-year-old kids and anybody else who decides to visit. And usually during that time, our pantry really does get disorganized. No matter how well I have it organized and cleaned up, once all the little kids get here, that is over. So it has become customary for us and for me to like give our pantry a once over right before the holidays. Clean it out, get out anything that has expired, bring old items to the front so I know to use them. And it keeps me organized, number one, in terms of not having to dig around looking for baking items that I'm going to be using over Thanksgiving and Christmas. It also keeps me from having to rebuy stuff that I already have that I just can't find. I mean, how many of us have done that? And I really, really like a well-stocked pantry. Everybody is different. Every family and their needs are different. So no two pantries are ever going to hold the same items. I think really what works for everybody is find what your family uses the most of, stock up on it, keep everything nice and tidy, and it will make life so much easier when you're in the kitchen trying to make meals or bake or anything else. So I'm going to give you a before look at my pantry so you can kind of get an idea of when I say disorganized, how disorganized it really was. And then I will take you inside and give you a complete detailed look on how everything is stored, how everything is organized, and hopefully it will give you some insight. So let's start over here. In this drawer right here, this is kind of like baking stuff. Let me just say that. I'll kind of back up. I am on a chair. I also have my really heavy-duty oven mitts right here. I have my everyday ones in the drawer in the kitchen, but these just live right here on the wall. But these are like super heavy-duty. Super, super. Anyway, so this is like baking stuff. And in this jar here is vanilla sugar. So after I scraped out the beans of this vanilla pod, I just added sugar into it. And I need to add some more, obviously. But my husband really likes this in his coffee. And it flavors it like no other. You can use this in recipes. It's amazing. And it's a great way to, you know, still get use out of your vanilla pods. In this jar is usually cinnamon sugar, but recently Scott and Jackson used it all, so I washed this and I need to make some more, but they love that on toast. And it's real simple. It's just, you know, some white sugar and some cinnamon, and sometimes I even grate in some nutmeg. But I keep that in this jar. I just need to add more. I should have done that before this video, but I can just tell you guys about it. And I love the vanilla sugar for baking. Speaking of baking, I have quite a few different flours. I have bread flour, and I like using, let me just get one out. It's easy to get out. These Rubbermaid containers, they're rather large. It can hold a whole bag of flour or sugar. And in this first one, I have bread flour. They stack two deep, so it's super nice. There's bread flour. Here's all-purpose flour. This is light brown sugar. This is self-rising flour. Powdered sugar. And I just used these labels I found at the store. White sugar. Baking cocoa. And these are so handy because I can pull it out. I can measure it straight from here if I really want to. And it's just very convenient. Everybody can find what they're looking for, even though I'm mainly the one who uses a shelf. My husband still can find what he's looking for if he's making French toast, wants some powdered sugar to sprinkle on top. He can easily find it. I also labeled the baking cocoa so they know it's not, you know,